I've always been very interested in sensing technologies. So when you first start electrical engineering, then you find all kinds of sensors. You know, there's infrared light, you have audio sensors and everything. And I thought, oh, that was very cool. And then at some point, you make some kind of connection and it's like, wait a minute, we can, you know an EEG exists, which is a way of measuring brain signals, but they are electrical sensors. If we can measure that, what else is there going on? Apparently all of our neurons are electrical signals. So there must be more things that we can do with that. And that just got me more and more interested in more kind of medical technologies.
I chose it because I had a technical background, but I wanted to go through more the biomedical part, so the health part, the helping people. Also because, yeah, my dad is a doctor. I wanted also to combine both technical and biomedical parts, and yeah, it's working till now.
Yeah. Well, you're doing your PhD, so it's working really well.
And for example, myself as an EE background people, we have this like our tools to do something. And to do what? In our case, we do it for the biomedical field. So for example, the health monitoring and the disease detections or monitorings, if you sum them up, we call it a biomedical signals and systems.
Biomedical signals and systems is basically any kind of physiological system you have in your body. So you have neurons running all the way from your brain all the way down to your feet, and all kinds of signals are traveling through there, controlling different processes. We can measure signals from like muscle contractions, and we can try to do analysis on those things in order to develop kinds of treatments.
When you did this specialization, did you find it hard coming from your, as you said before, very technical background to implement the more biomedical engineering parts?
It was different for sure. I was more towards physics, but I still had to learn a lot of how the body works. That was completely new for me. And how the physics applied to the body and the biomechanics and all these things, that it was quite interesting.
It's very much oriented on the medical side of things. There's also lots of biomedical students walking around here, but in essence, it is still electrical engineering. So you learn ways to analyze those systems a little bit like an electrical engineer. So you discover that things like neurons, which are inherently chemical processes with ions leaving a neuron or entering a neuron, which change the potential. But we can model that as an electrical circuit. We understand a lot about the world around us, but not about ourselves. And being able to analyze on a very fundamental level the signals that run around in our bodies that we don't really understand, I thought was really fascinating and just really got me interested in learning more.
I also have many opportunities to contact patients, to listen to their stories, to really hear what they really need or something. Then we can really, co-design our technologies. And when I contact them and they express their desire, their passions, something like that, this really influenced me as well. When I heard that they really expect something from our system and they really need it, that is really something make me also feel very proud, because I know I'm the one can help them and I can really bring something for them.
When I started this master, one of the first courses I had was physiology, because you start learning about biology, you learn biomedical systems, and you need to learn human physiology. And that is something I didn't think I would be doing as an electrical engineer. I was like, all right, so I'm going to do electrical engineering, and then all of the biology stuff is behind me. But no, here I am again, learning more anatomy, learning more physiology, learning how human sensing is supposed to work. And that was a very interesting perspective, because you also look at it with a new perspective. You learn it from the perspective of an electrical engineer, and you also look at it from that context. You don't look at it as some magical system in your brain anymore. You can see it for individual components, and you start seeing little bits of mechanism where you're like, oh, right, this is a neuron that goes there. You have a kind of a sensing hair that triggers a signal, and that is processed further in the brain.
Then bioelectromagnetics is quite interesting. It's in simulations on the brain, but also in any human body part, like the eyes and muscles. I really liked the human movement control. It was about all the biomechanics of the body, how people walk and how to improve, and also It was a lot of math as well. I really like it.
The movement control was more about the biomechanics behind that movement. How our neural activations of our muscles, a muscle starts to contract, and then from there we get movement. But what is the relation between how much I want my muscle to move versus how much it actually moves? There is a signal here that I have a thought that I want to move this arm, and then that somewhere that is translated to a signal that travels to this muscle that then contracts. But it's not actually just this muscle that contracts. There's also the opposite muscle that contracts, because otherwise it would just fly away. And human movement control really gets into how the neural circuits behind that start working, because the different muscles are linked to each other. So once you contract a certain muscle, another muscle will automatically necessarily also contract. And these are things that also that you start analyzing in human movement control.
I had courses from digital control to human movement, but also like signal analysis. We there worked with EEG, so signals from the brain, but also movement data.
That course is also very important for EE students in this specialization, because you see what we're talking about is more like systems, but without signals, you never know what exactly happened on human body. So therefore, for example, heart rate is a very commonly seen signals from the healthcare domain, but there are a lot of information we can extract from the heart activities. And also in daily life, there are a lot of noises can influence these signal qualities. So therefore you do need signal processing and signal analysis techniques for the specific biomedical applications. So this is also very important for students. Another course, not offered directly by our BSS group, but it's also very important for the research part, for example, also for the application of the daily monitoring, that is machine learning. So I think machine learning is a very popular course in other domains as well. I would say the same importance it has for our BSS track.
One of my favorite courses, for instance, is Dynamical Behavior of Neuronal Networks, which is a very complex name, which basically you start modeling individual neurons. So you start from an anatomy, you start with a neuron, and you start looking at first a way to abstract the electrochemical composition of a neuron and try to model it as an electrical circuit. And then from there, we can make simulations of that. So we made a network of about 20 neurons, and you try to induce a particular behavior. You start interconnecting them, and the neurons, they start talking to each other through our modeled synapses. And it's really cool to see that you can evoke a certain kind of behavior by configuring particular neurons in a certain way, having different clusters that have a particular effect. You can have an inhibitory cluster or an excitatory cluster, and they can affect each other's in particular ways.
And what you will learn is like to how to apply the one you learned from your bachelor, like the fundamental knowledge or fundamental techniques in the specific domain. So in our case, it's a biomedical domain because what you learned in the past 3 years from your bachelor is a very, very basic things. And the only challenging things, I mean, the difficult thing is how to use such techniques in the specific problems.
Within this program, there's actually a lot of choice. So there's only a couple courses that are really set in stone to do this specialization, but there's a lot of choice for you to pick for yourself. So I actually picked a lot of courses that maybe pertain a little bit more to things like integrated circuit design. So I had courses like system and chip design, and I had courses such as analog electronics.
I teach a course called Biological Control System, and in that course we do apply the techniques and even develop the techniques for the dynamic modelings or the control system knowledge for the real human healthcare applications. So that is, for example, for the clinical disease, for example, for people with diabetes, and how the glucose regulated in the body, and then how this can be monitored in daily life. And then from this kind of monitoring, how we can indicate the health condition of the people with diabetes. But this is just one example, because the human body is really complex, so we do need this technique knowledge, but apply it in the human body and for the healthcare field. So this is the master course we teach, and also a EE student is very, very important for this course.
I like that many of the courses also have a practical aspect. So you don't just are doing math, but you're also making a MATLAB script, like trying to simulate the behavior that you analyzed before in math. Is really fascinating, and you can really work with a group. Yeah, you get to work together and communicate about how you're going to tackle a particular problem, and that really helps with reflecting on how these systems work and get a better understanding.
Some students are a bit scared to start the program because they think it's too medical, essentially. Is that correct?
It depends what exactly the scaring point it is. I understand it's okay. Medicine is something totally different than the technique field. So this is indeed when I joined this field at the very beginning, I was also hesitate or question myself, like, hey, whether I'm the one I can do it. But I have one tip. It's a really, really useful tip. Is as long as you keep open-minded, and then it's okay. So I think for any pure technology student, if they want, they can really learn the background knowledge, the medicine knowledge, and not only by themselves, but also with the help of relevant experts. So that is okay. I will not be scared anymore if I heard this right several years ago when I joined this field. So I think this is the same tip for them.
In my master's thesis, I am designing a system that is being used in research in nociceptive processing. Nociceptive processing is the way we process pain. So when we feel pain, you know, when you pull a hair from your arm, you feel pain. But what really is that? Because in essence, it is again an electrical signal that travels through here. But we actually have specific neurons that sense pain. But what is the relation between how strong this signal is and how much pain I feel? Specifically, the system I am working on is looking at detection thresholds. So in the test setup, we have an electrical stimulator. And then on the other side, we have sort of a feedback button, which we use for subject feedback. So they can give feedback whether they felt a sensation or not. And we start increase or decrease the amplitude that we give. Yeah, and then we can try to figure out where is the threshold between no, I don't feel anything, and yes, I feel anything. There is a point where we're not sure we felt anything. There is a point where it's about 50-50, and that is the point we're looking for. For example, if you have your arm or your leg amputated, there's a lot of nerves that are just exposed then, and you can tie that off, but nerves kind of do regrow, and sometimes that goes wrong. Sometimes you have a clump of neurons that forms, and it becomes very sensitive. And that's when these people start experiencing just very hypersensitivity or just continuous pain from joints or particular nerves. And those kinds of neuropathies are things we can look for with these tests.
And what for you, because you already said you have your green light, you're almost done with your master thesis. What's in store for you after that? Where are you going? What are you doing?
Yeah, I'm probably going to go looking for a job. There's a couple companies here, near here, that I might be interested in. I was looking at TMSI, who make EEG machines and all of the software that supports those things. And it's very close, and they do a lot of fun things. It's a very fun team, or so I've heard. Okay, there's a couple people here at the group, at the research group here, that also came from TMSI.
Because the healthcare field is really growing and growing because of the needs of healthcare is huge. So therefore, it's very easy for them to find a job. But also, not only the companies, but also hospitals. And in hospitals, they also need technique background people who know the biomedical knowledge, but also who also know how to use the techniques, how to even develop the techniques for their needs.
I'm also looking at, Demcon is closed, but they also have a medical department For instance, they make different kinds of biomedical sensing equipment, such as sensors. A little bit further away from here, I am looking at IMEC. IMEC is a company based in Leuven, Belgium, and they do a lot of research into neurostimulation. They are also in Eindhoven, if I don't want to go to Belgium.
Of course, you can always stay at the university as a researcher. What we are always want our students to stay longer.
This place is where you could say all of the magic happens. In this lab, we have all of our testing equipment, where we can solder our custom PCBs, where we can test certain systems, but also here we perform real experiments that we use in research or other master theses. So it's kind of a production floor, a testing floor, and an experimental site all crammed into one. Once you really get into producing and testing and things, then suddenly you start spending a lot of time, you start spending whole days here just to make sure that your little system does what it's supposed to do.
Welcome to the e-house house. It looks like a regular house.
But it is right here at the Tech Math Center.
So in such kind of environment, you can really have the simulated like live environment for your participant. So this exactly help our real life daily monitoring healthcare study. And when the participants come, they can really cook here, and all of these things are real. And you can see there's several cameras here, there. So using these cameras, we can know exactly the physical activities the participant is doing during this simulation environment experiment. So this is the sleep room. So people can really take a shower here. Oh, see, this is how it works. Oh, and another thing is there's no camera here. It's for the privacy. So there are several cameras, but we also have researchers who will stay at the control room and can observe what happens through the glasses over there. And we can observe the participant over here, but also we can communicate with the participant using this a microphone, and they can also hear it in the e-house house. Half year ago, we did elderly experiment here, and we invited around 30 elderly, like 80 plus years old, come to this e-health house. And they come here for the general daily life activities, just walk around and doing the kitchen or other like living room or bed, like for sleeping activities, etc. And during this experiment, we have some sensors, some variable sensors on them, and then we can really collect the signals from their during their physical activities. And also later, after this experiment finished, we can analyze it and then develop the daily life monitoring systems.
Let's say I am a third year electrical engineering student, bachelor, and I'm gonna look for a specialization for my master. Why should I pick this one?
Ah, yes, I like this question. I think this is also the question I ask myself when I was an EE bachelor student. I mean, I tell myself, like, I want to do something for me, for myself, more meaningful. And what kind of things is meaningful for myself? I think to help people, like to help a human being and to make a human being like healthy and also happy in their life, etc. But if I see myself, I was a girl and learned a lot of techniques. I know a lot of toolbox and how to use it, etc. So in the biomedical field, there are a lot of clinicians and a lot of people who specifically work on the healthcare. But they really need our support. They need customized tools from the people like ours. So therefore, if we say, hi, I really want to use my techniques to help human, then there you go. So this is the choice, yeah.